So earlier this week, I had a pretty self-defeating and negative thought experience where I'm like everyone watching this video. I have a ton of stuff that I want to do, goals, aspirations, projects, visions for what do I want to accomplish with my life. And I also have a lot going on. I have a full-time job. I have this blog, freelancing projects. I have my girlfriend. I go to the gym. There's a lot going on. And I had this feeling of overwhelm and thinking, oh my gosh, I don't have enough time. How am I going to do everything? How am I going to accomplish everything? There's just not enough time in the week. And what was interesting was that while I was having this self-defeating and negative thought experience, something effulged out of my chest. And it was a thought of pure truth and knowingness. And it came forth and it said, I have time for what's most important. I have time for what's most important. And it stopped me dead in my tracks because it's completely true. Every single person on this planet has 24 hours a day and 365 days in a year. But if you track the lives of many different people, you'll find that successful people accomplish insane amounts more than unsuccessful people. And the reality is that you would be fulfilled in life if you spent all of your time or the majority of your time working on what is most important, because you would always get done what is most important. Therefore, you would be fulfilled, successful, happy, and rich. So in this video, I'm gonna share with you guys what we can do to get ourselves in a position where we're actually doing what is most important to us most of the time. I'm gonna paint a picture for you guys. Let's say that it's your day off. It's your day off from work and you have a ton going on. You have a lot that you wanna do. And today you have 10 tasks on your list. Now, let's take the 80-20 principle. Two of those tasks are going to be worth vastly more than all the eight other tasks combined. And let's say that this week it is writing a book that you've been meaning to work on and cold calling a business that you've been wanting to work with. So those are your two major important tasks that would actually change your life. And then the other eight tasks on your list are of minor importance, but they feel like they're important. They're busy work that feels important. It's doing the laundry, it's sending a few emails, and it's giving a call to that friend that you haven't talked to in forever. And what happens to most people who fail to plan is that they end up waking up and they're like, oh my gosh, I have so much going on. Here's my list. Okay, and they get right to work. And they work all day long, and at the end of the day, they ended up procrastinating on the two very tasks that would actually have a significant impact in their life, which is writing the book and making the cold call. And this is the story of most people's lives. It's very interesting, but for humans, what is often most important to us is what we actually procrastinate on. And the reason is that what is most important is usually what is most difficult, scary, what has the most fear of failure and rejection involved, and it's the easiest to procrastinate and not do. And there's a very famous quote that says, "Failure to plan is the same thing as planning to fail." And I think that this is so true because if you don't know what is most important, there is absolutely no way that you're gonna go from doing what's most important to what's second most important to what's third most important to what's fourth most important. If you don't clearly know what those tasks are and your priority ranking among them, there's no way that you're going to work on what is most important. I think that it is literally impossible to plan too much. And what this will look like for your life, if you want to set it up so you're always doing what's most important, will be planning the next day the night before. So always creating a plan, understanding what you need to do, and then ranking them in order of importance and priority. And then I think one of the smartest things you can ever do for your life is personal strategic planning. So if you take a look at companies and organizations, you'll realize that the majority of time is spent actually planning, strategizing, organizing, and creating plans of action in order to succeed. The upper level management and executives, they're always creating plans, delegating responsibility, setting deadlines in order of importance and priority, and then they work on that all year long, and they're constantly going back and reviewing what the strategies that they've created and how they're working out. So we should be doing this the same way that a corporation does this for their business. We should be doing this for ourselves as individuals. And what this would look like for you would be every Sunday taking an hour or two to go over your past week, to set goals, to see where you're at, to think about what's important. Because the reality is, if you just plan once, which I've been an example of this, sometimes I've only planned once and then I haven't gone back and reviewed my plans. But the fact is that we don't really know exactly how to achieve what we're looking for. And as you go, you're gonna trip up and fall a million different times. And it's important to create plans and then to review them, revise them, see what's working, what's not, and to go back and kind of change the picture. So I hope you guys like this video. Hit the like button below and definitely comment with what you think about this subject. For me, when I think about what is most important, I have time for what is most important, that gets me emotional inside. So comment with what you think about that. And definitely, if you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button. I make videos on personal development like this, time management, minimalism, and spirituality. So if you like those subjects, definitely hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you guys next week. Ciao.